Generative AI, or Gen AI, is exploding onto the scene with new capabilities for business and personal use. Unlike earlier generations of AI, which could analyze data and make predictions, generative AI mimics human creativity to produce content that wasn't there before. I'm joined by Beena Ammanath, who leads Deloitte's Global U.S. Technology Trust Ethics. Beena, it's hard to remember the last time a technology emerged this forcefully, this fast. The possibilities are extremely exciting, but the risks, they deserve some attention too.
That's so true, Lara. For example, creativity isn't the only human trait Gen AI can imitate. It can also hallucinate, creating outputs that aren't true. Gen AI can be led astray by bad source data the same way a human being can. Other trust and reliability issues that have surrounded AI in the past are accelerated when the power of Gen AI comes into play. We must ask, is it fair and impartial, transparent and explainable, safe and secure, accountable, responsible, and private? To be trustworthy, Gen AI must have all these traits. Each one is an avenue for risk.
Let's take a closer look at one of these risk domains, fair and impartial.
From the first days of computing, we've known the results that come out are only as good as the data that goes in. Adding power and sophistication doesn't eliminate that risk. It amplifies it and makes it harder to see or address.
And of course, when the training and testing of the data is subject to bias, the AI outputs can be biased too. This can create real-world harms when people and organizations use those outputs to make crucial decisions.
Exactly. Some potential biases may be hard to see. For example, a Gen AI chatbot may produce natural-sounding dialogue, but for only some languages or cultural groups. Versions for other languages may lack nuance or precision. That means one audience is getting more value than others. It's up to organizations to challenge the data they use, to identify, remedy, and remove bias before it goes into a Gen AI application, not after.
Now, let's talk about the need for this technology to be transparent and explainable.
When machines can imitate humans, does it matter whether users can tell the difference? To someone who's basing an important financial or medical decision on the information they're receiving, it absolutely matters.
And people need to know if they're acting on machine-derived results. They need a clear explanation of how a recommendation was made. And they need the ability to opt out or restrict the use of an output if they choose. It can be hard to know what you're dealing with a Gen AI system. So it may be necessary to explicitly inform users with a watermark or a notation.
Yes, it's only when people know they're using AI-derived results that they can ask the important questions about the data used or the model that processed it. The more believable the masquerade, the greater the potential negative impact.
Now, let's talk about the need for this technology to be safe and secure.
Intentionally or not, Gen AI has a powerful capacity to mislead. Malicious, manipulative, or inaccurate information can spread farther and do more damage if its source appears human and trustworthy. These risks run in both directions. One practice called spoofing happens when users craft inputs to trick an AI system into divulging information it shouldn't.
And people have also used AI to reverse engineer systems and expose underlying information.
Yes, we all know bad information travels so quickly that it's hard for the truth to catch up. Gen AI permits real-time content creation, personalization, and translation that's so fast it may exceed human capacity to counteract it. That's why it's vital to build in safeguards from the very beginning.
Now, let's talk about the need for this technology to be accountable.
Making ethical decisions about an AI application depends on understanding the underlying model. With Gen AI, that understanding can be more complicated. Ultimately, it's up to humans and their judgment to keep AI users accountable. Consider a business that creates an AI-driven virtual spokesperson that can make claims, post on social media, and even reach out to customers on its own.
I see where you're going. What if that spokesperson builds relationships with individual consumers, interacts with other brands, or even spreads misleading information about competitors.
Yes, a human who behaved that way would be easy to rein in. A Gen AI application can operate so fast at such a scale that it may be hard to keep up with. That's why the Gen AI model has to remain closely tied to the business and its standards of behavior, because it's the business that will be ultimately held accountable for everything the model does.
Now, let's talk about the need for this technology to be responsible.
Any tool can be misused. Gen AI takes that risk to a new level. Most people have seen deep fakes that replace one celebrity's face with another. What about a video that puts words in the mouth of a deep faked political candidate, or appears to show a deadly military attack that never actually happened? Deceptions that were once barely feasible with large resources are becoming easy to pull off from a desktop. When Gen AI is used irresponsibly, the damage can be enormous.
And content is only part of the equation, right? The systems that run Gen AI models use huge amounts of energy for power and cooling. That means there are environmental impacts alongside informational ones.
It's up to the enterprise leaders to set standards for responsible Gen AI use and enforce them internally. And to do that, they first need to understand what's at stake.
Now, let's talk about the need for this technology to be private.
A lot of the information that flows through a Gen AI model may be sensitive or personally identifiable. Think of medical records, financial transactions, product designs, contract terms. Think of anything you consider private for whatever reasons matter to you.
So the controls to keep private data private have to come from the organization, not from the technology. The approaches that work may include removing some data, obscuring it, aggregating it, or even blocking some kinds of data from entering the system in the first place.
As with many Gen AI issues, this is a frontier we are still exploring. If a model creates something new, who owns it? Who has the economic and moral rights, or even a copyright, to machine-generated insights and the value they create? Safeguarding privacy in the era of Gen AI is just as morally vital as it was in the age of paper records. It's just a lot harder.
And to maximize the power of Gen AI for all humans, we need to understand and mitigate all of these risks. We need as much innovation in governance and risk mitigation as we need in the development and deployment.
That's right, Lara. Deloitte has taken a leading role in answering these needs. Through our Global AI Institute, we help organizations align people, processes, and technologies so safety and reliability are baked into AI development from the start. When we manage risks and rewards with the same energy and dedication, Gen AI can be a net positive. The more people find they can trust this new technology, the more we can all share in its benefits.